back to the channel. I am back in the John Ruda 389. We're still working on the tires, mileage-wise and everything. And I figured we'd do like a short little run to put some more miles on it. Figured I'd talk about how I want to start changing the channel a little bit. Maybe putting some more, do some longer hauls, do some more interior runs, and start utilizing the backing up into spaces instead of just doing the pull in like I always do, and actually try to back the stuff in instead of my normal just pull in. So and today I got my display port cable running at 165 hertz on my monitor now. It does look a lot better. I mean, at night where we're doing a nighttime run, it's not really nighttime, it's about, let's see, about 3:50 in the morning. So it'll be daylight here in a little bit and I'll see how much clearer it is. But right now, I mean, I can actually see a difference in the dark of how much better it is with 165 hertz rolling. So and this is with the JBX graphics mod as well. So let's start it up and get rolling. Changed up the engine a little bit, decided we could use a different sound. I think I'm, what did I put in this? I think I put the, what did I put? 3406 or 3206 or, I don't know, it's like 3000 something engine. I think that's what it was, or it might be the King of the Hill cat engine. Don't remember, I already forgot what I put in it. I did it like yesterday. The day before when I was making videos, but I figured if you hear the sound, you'll figure it out. Still raining whenever I stopped the video and everything, and the decided to take a sleep. I slept the first time, it was still raining, and it was nighttime, and I went on ahead and went back to sleep to kick up some time. And now we're at the, should be getting daylight here soon. Did that so that way it wouldn't rain no more. Wow. This display port's a lot better. Getting about almost 100 frames. Well, not close to it, but like 80. I'm in the high 80s. Which is a lot better than what I was having. So, that's a plus. I turned down the scaling down to 200% instead of 300. I could have had it on to help out with the frames so we can like keep from lagging. Yeah, I'm doing the I just got a external market job picking up this from just a local place, so I'm not using my own trailers, which I'll probably go back to using my own trailers here soon. Because I really like my trailers, especially from John Ruda, the USA trailer pack. And it's just one price to get all the trailers that he's already made. And you get free updates every time. So every time an update comes out, you know, you get the free update without having to pay you another $20. Just what I like. It's a lot better than some. A lot don't make that expensive, like $5, $10 or anything, but I like the one-time pay type deal. That's just me. I know a lot of people don't like payware mods, but if you ask me, I mean, it's freebies versus pay. They're dedicated for the payware and everything. The updates are going to keep coming out, and they're going to keep pushing to make things better, versus somebody's making a freebie for the first time, or, you know, been doing it for a little bit, but then all of a sudden, you know, don't commit to, let's just say they get bored with it, don't want to do it anymore, they just drop the updates and everything, they don't want to update anymore. I've seen that happen on some of them, they just don't update them anymore. It's kind of a good deal. It's just a one-time pay. I got off a little early today, earlier than I usually do. And figured I'd make up another video. But I'm scheduling each one of my videos to come out at certain times. I'm thinking about posting my own convoy. Once I get my, Ethernet cable in, I've been having a lot of issues with this Wi-Fi crap, this USB adapter, because whenever I bought the computer, I didn't think about if it said it came with Wi-Fi card or not, and it doesn't, and the motherboard is not built for Wi-Fi, so there's like no Wi-Fi outlet for it to put a card in to make Wi-Fi. So, which is weird, because I figured all motherboards had that option. Apparently they don't. I guess this one doesn't. And I've tried looking in their website and everything, and at the motherboard and everything. And I don't know if I should just go ahead and call them up and ask them about that and everything. Not sure on that what I'll do, but from the looks of it, I can't put a Wi-Fi card in it. Get the better quality Wi-Fi. It's always just going to be a USB. So, and I'm just done with the USB ones because I've already went through two and both of them are crap. I just had nothing but issues and having issues uploading. Like whenever I upload my videos, it just crashes. And I have to do it like 2 or 3 times before it actually takes. So I don't know if they're just overheating or what. It's weird. just went ahead and got me a cable cord to run to my router. That way I can I think I'm getting like 400 megs per second internet. That way I don't have any lag or anything like that. High latency, basically. Because every time I go to play World of Warcraft, I seem to, it does fine at first, but I think when it gets hot or something, it just kind of craps out, in a sense. So, I don't know, we'll see when my cord gets here. And it's a real good one too. It's actually a flat cord that's a round, so that way I can just run it through underneath doors without having it pinch. We're getting stuck underneath the door and having to pinch it and destroy my cord. So that'll help out a whole lot. It's a high quality top cord. Made like $30 for it. It's a Cat 7 Ethernet cord. I was debating on getting a Cat 8, but they were a little bit more expensive. And I needed at least 100 foot so I could like run it through the way I want to. Once I get all that set up and everything is, I'm gonna start hosting my own convoy. Maybe just thinking about joining somebody's convoy. But we'll see you down the road. How it's gonna go. And I wanna try to see about learning how to make my own skin for these trucks. So that way I can create my own logo. I got another profile set up to do so. So I can create my own logo and my own transport name and everything. Gotta get rid of this migraine right now. Lately I've been getting headaches after work every day. I don't know what it is. Maybe stressing to get done with my work. Too much stress. Too much stress. I do plan on making some changes to my profile and everything on this YouTube channel. And maybe I can do better intros and exit out content and everything. I'll go from there with it and see what we can do to kind of brighten it up a little bit. That way, you know, let's do one just for the heck of it. That way I can, looks like they would be parked there, so I'm sweeping them. That way I can give y'all better content and everything, and keep y'all interested in my content, all that sort of thing. Now, should we do this on the interior, it'd be a lot more challenging. But we'll do that in maybe another video. There it is. John Ritter's 389 glider with the Black Swan transport skin by Goggles 56. I do plan on changing my channel up a little bit, make it more exciting, or try to at least get y'all engaged to what I'm doing. With this one, we are trying to see what happens when the tires go bad. I'm trying to see here, what am I at? There it is. I'm at 45%, which doing short runs and everything does not help. I have to do long runs, so we may do a series of it to get it a little higher, doing longer runs, and probably do it in like two different parts or something like that. So that way y'all don't have to watch like a full hour of something. I'll do like 30 minutes of video or something like that, but we'll figure out what we can do to make it more engaging, keep you all interested, and pretty much just have fun with it, because I'm really digging this 389. I know I have that 362 from John Ruda and the Freightliner, but I don't know, I guess maybe where this was my first payware mod or truck that I really liked. I'm a Peterbilt guy. This is like probably my favorite style of Peterbilt, and I went on ahead and changed the headlights on it, if you couldn't tell from older style. And on the interior, I went with the wood dash with a wood floor interior and everything. Really nice, really nice interior. Went with a SISL's Mega Pack wheel, 3-spoke, which looks really nice with it, I think. Gives it an older kind of feel. Kind of wish they had a little bit more steering wheel options for it, but this is probably one I like the most, because a lot of the trucks are built off the newer trucks. But we need some more. I think we need some more interior odor dashes with the switches and everything. But that's just me. Everybody else can, you know, they have the way they like their trucks. I'd just like to see an odor one made. But other than that, I shall see you all in the next one.